semiconductors. Question number one. The electrical conductivity of a semiconductor increases when electromagnetic radiation of wavelength shorter than 2500 meter is incident on it. What is the band gap energy in EV for the semiconductor? Planck constant H is equal to 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second. Now to solve this question, we know this is 2500 nanometer NM. Now to solve this question, we know Eg is equal to H nu Hc upon lambda, which is equal to 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 into 3 into 10 raised to 8 upon 2500 into 10 raised to minus 9 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Which on solving we get 6.63 into 3 upon 25 into 1.6, which is equivalent to 0.5 EV. So option D, 0.5 electron volt EV, is the correct answer. In an intrinsic semiconductor, number of conduction electron is 6 into 10 raised to 19 per cubic meter. How many holes are there in semiconductor of size 1 cm into 1 cm into 1 mm? Now, in a pure semiconductor, number of electrons is equal to number of holes. In pure semiconductor, number of electron is equal to number of holes. Volume of semiconductor is equal to 10 raised to minus 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 meter cube. Number of holes. Is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 into 6 into 10 raised to 19. So which on solving we get 6 into 10 raised to 12. So option C, 6 into 10 raised to 12 is the correct answer. Choose the false statement from the following. Option A, the conductivity of a semiconductor increase with increase in temperature. Option B, the valence and the conduction band overlaps in most of the cases. Option C, substances with energy gap of the order of 10 EV are insulators. Option D, the resistivity of a semiconductor increases in the temperature, or I can say resistivity of semiconductor increases with increase in temperature. Now to solve this question, we know that for a semiconductor conductivity increases with temperature, its resistivity decreases with increase in temperature. If conductivity is increasing with temperature, so I can see resistivity will decrease with increase in temperature. So option D, resistivity of semiconductor for increase with increase in temperature, is the false statement. In the energy band diagram of a material shown below, the open circles are filled circle and the filled circles are denoted holes and electrons respectively. The material is option A, an insulator, option B, a metal, option C, N-type semiconductor, option D, P-type semiconductor. Now, we know that the material shown here is a P-type semiconductor because in the valence band, holes are the majority charge carriers. So option D, P-type semiconductor is the correct answer. A silicon specimen is converted into a P-type semiconductor by doping in on the average 1 indium atom per 5 into 10 raised to 7 silicon atoms. If the number density of atom in the silicon specimen is 5 into 10 raised to 23 atoms per meter cube, then the number of atom acceptor in silicon will be. Now to solve this question, we know indium atom acts an acceptor atom in P-type semiconductor. So number of silicon atom per meter cube, atoms per meter cube is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 28 atom per meter cube. So 1 meter cube is equal to 10 raised to 6 centimeter cube. Number of silicon atoms number of silicon atoms per meter cube per centimeter cube is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 28 upon 10 raised to 6, which on solving we get 5 into 10 raised to 22 atoms per centimeter cube. Number of indium atom accepted atom in silicon, number of indium atom or acceptor atom is 5 into 10 raised to 22 upon 5 into 10 raised to 7, which on solving get 10 raised to 15 atoms per centimeter cube. So 1 into 10 raised to 15 atom per centimeter cube, option B is the correct answer. In case of a semiconductor, which one of the following statement is wrong? Option A, doping increases with conductivity. Option B, temperature coefficient of resistance is negative. Option D, resistivity is in between that of conductor and insulator. Option D, at absolute zero temperature, it behaves like a conductor. Now we know that at absolute zero temperature, it behaves like an insulator. It will behave like an insulator. So it does not behave like a conductor. So option D is the wrong. As we know, it is wrong because absolute zero temperature, it behaves like insulator, not as conductor. The energy gap of silicon is 1.14 eV. What is the maximum wavelength at which silicon will begin absorbing energy? So we know E is equal to h nu, which is equal to h c by lambda, where lambda max is equal to h c upon E, which is equal to 6.6 into 10 raised to minus 34 into 3 into 10 raised to 8 upon 1.14 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19, which is equal to 6.6 into 3 upon 1.14 into 1.6, which on solving we get 10, multiply by 10 raised to minus 7 meter, which on solving we get 10.86 into 10 raised to minus 7 into 10 raised to 10 angstrom, which is equal to 10860 angstrom. So option B, 10860 angstrom, is the correct answer. The forbidden energy gap in germanium is 0.72 eV, given Hc is equal to 12400 eV angstrom. What is the maximum wavelength of radiation that will generate electron hole pairs? Now we know Eg is equal to Hc upon lambda, maximum wavelength, lambda max is equal to Hc upon Eg, which is equal to 12400 eV upon 0.72 eV, which is equal to 1722 angstrom. So option C, 1722 angstrom, is the correct answer. In a pure silicon, Ni is 10 raised to 16 per meter cube crystal at 300 Kelvin. 10 raised to 21 atoms of phosphorus are added per cubic meter. What is the new hole concentration? Now for intrinsic semiconductor, Ni is equal to 10 raised to 16 per meter cube, NH is equal to Ne, and when phosphorus, that is pentavalent impurity, is added, it becomes N-type semiconductor. So Ne is equal to 10 raised to 21 per meter cube, NH is equal to Ni square upon Ne, which is equal to 10 raised to 16 into 10 raised to 16 upon N is 10 raised to 21, which on solving we get 10 raised to 11 per meter cube. So option B, 10 raised to 11 per meter cube, is the correct answer. A pure germanium crystal contains 8 into 10 raised to 27 atoms per meter cube. It is converted into P-type semiconductor by doping it with gallium atoms in the proportion of gallium atom per 4 to 10 raised to 6 germanium atoms. How many gallium atoms are present per centimeter cube of the semiconductor? Now, number of germanium atoms per meter cube is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 27. तो नंबर ऑफ जर्मेनियम एटम पर सेंटीमीटर एटम्स पर सेंटीमीटर नंबर ऑफ जर्मेनियम एटम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब इज इक्वल टू 8 इंटू 20 10 रेज टू 27 8 इंटू 10 रेज टू 27 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 10 रेज टू माइनस 6 एज इट इज पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब विच गिव्स अस 8 इंटू 10 रेज टू 21. सो नंबर ऑफ गैलियम एटम्स पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब नंबर ऑफ गैलियम एटम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब इज इक्वल टू 8 इंटू 10 रेज टू 21 अपॉन 4 इंटू 10 रेज टू 6 विच गिव्स अस 2 इंटू 10 रेज टू 15. सो ऑप्शन सी 2 इंटू 10 रेज टू 15 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. प्योर सिलिकॉन एट 500 केल्विन हैज इक्वल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड होल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ 1.5 इंटू 10 रेज टू 16 मीटर पर मीटर क्यूब. डोपिंग बाय इंडियम इंक्रीजेस NH to 4.5 to 10 raised to 22 meter per meter cube. The doped semiconductor is of. Now we know NHNe is equal to Ni square, where Ne is equal to Ni square upon NH, which is equal to 1.5 into 10 raised to 16 into 1.5 into 10 raised to 16 upon 4.5 into 10 raised to 22. So electron concentration Ne is equal to 0.5 into 10 raised to 10, which is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 9 per meter cube. That is option B. P type having electron concentration Ne is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 9 per meter cube. If the ratio of the concentration of electron to that of holes in a semiconductor is 7/5 and that the ratio of the corresponding current is 7/4, then what is the ratio of the drift velocities? So now we know Ne upon NH is equal to 7/5, IE upon IH is equal to 7/4. Drift velocity VD is equal to I upon NEA. So VD is inversely proportional to N and directly proportional to I. So now we can write VE upon VH is equal to IE upon IH multiplied by NH upon NE, which is 7/4 into 5/7. 7 and 7 gets cancelled, we are left with 5/4. So option A, 5/4 is the correct answer. Silicon diode is given in the above circuit. So in the above circuit, the voltage drop across the resistance R is. So now we know potential difference over here, potential difference PD is equal to 0.6 volt. For silicon, the barrier potential difference is 0.6 volt. Potential difference across R is equal to 3 minus 0.6, which will give us 2.4 volt. So option C, 2.4 volt is the correct answer. In a PN junction, the thickness of depletion layer is 10 raised to minus 6 meter. If the potential difference across it is 0.2 volt, then the electric field set up across its junction is. Now, we know E is equal to V by D, which is equal to 0.2 upon 10 raised to minus 6, which is 0.2 into 10 raised to 6. E is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 volt per meter. So 2 into 10 raised to 5 volt per meter, that is option B, is the correct answer. If the forward bias voltage of a junction diode is increased from 0.8 to 2 volt, the current increases by 4 milliampere, the forward resistance of the diode is. Now to solve this question, we know RF is equal to delta V upon delta I, 2 minus 0.8 upon 4 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is 1.2 into 10 raised to 3 upon 4. Which on solving we get 300 ohms. So option C, 300 ohms is the correct answer. The width of the depletion region in a PN junction diode is 400 nanometer and at intense electric field of 8 into 10 raised to 5 volt per meter exists in it. What is the kinetic energy which a conduction electron must have in order to diffuse from the region to P region, from N region to P region? Now we know E is equal to dV by dx. So dV is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 5 into 400 into 10 raised to minus 9, which is equal to 32 into 10 raised to minus 2, which is equal to 0.32 volt. But the minimum kinetic energy of the electron to cross potential difference, potential barrier U, is equal to E into V. That is minimum kinetic energy of electron to cross the potential barrier U. To cross potential barrier U is E into V, which is equal to 0.32 electron volt. So option D, 0.32 electron volt, is the correct answer. A junction diode is forward biased if the forward voltage increase from 0.4 volt to 0.7 volt, the forward current changes by 1.5 milliampere. What is the forward resistance of the junction diode? Now, we know RF is equal to delta V upon delta I, which is equal to 0.3 upon 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 3, which on solving we get 200 ohms. So option D, 200 ohms, is the correct. What is the resistivity of diode circuit between A and B, and D1 and D2 are ideal diodes? Now we know no current flows through D2, D2 is here, no current is flowing to D2. Therefore, R dash, that is resistance between A and C, is given by one upon 4 plus 1 upon 12 is equal to 1 upon 3, which is equal to 1 upon R dash. So value for R dash is equal to 3. So total resistance between A and B is equal to 3 plus 7, which is equal to 10 ohm. So option D, 10 ohm, is the correct answer. In a PN junction, the thickness of depletion region is 10 raised to minus 5 meter. What is the potential difference that should be applied across it to produce an electric field of intensity 10 raised to 5 volt per meter? Now we know E is equal to minus dV by dx. So dV is equal to edx, which is equal to 10 raised to 5 into 10 raised to minus 5, which is equal to 1 volt. So option C, 1 volt, is the correct answer. A PN junction diode has forward bias resistance of 10 ohm and a reverse bias resistance of 10 kilo ohm. If it is connected in series with a resistance of 990 ohm and a DC source, a direct current source of 5 volt, in such a way that negative terminal of the source is connected to the region of PN junction, what is the current flowing in the circuit? Now we know current diode is forward biased, therefore the current I is equal to V upon R plus RF, which is equal to 5 upon 990 plus 10, which is equal to 5 milliampere. So option B, 5 milliampere, is the correct answer. A potential barrier of 0.5 volt exists across a PN junction. What is the width of the depletion region if a constant electric field of magnitude 10 raised to 5 volt per meter exists in depletion region? Now we know E is equal to dV by dx. So dx is equal to dV by E, which is equal to 0.5 upon 10 raised to 5, which is equal to 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter, which is equal to 5 micrometer. So option B, 5 micrometer, is the correct answer. What is the current through an ideal PN junction diode shown below? Now we know that the resistance of ideal diode is 0 and the potential on the N side, is more negative than the P side. So D is forward biased, therefore D is forward biased. With net EMF is equal to minus 1 minus minus 3, which is equal to 2 volt. So I is equal to 2 upon 100, which is equal to 0.2 ampere, which is equal to 20 milliampere. So option C, 20 milliampere is the correct answer. A junction diode has a resistance of 25 ohm when forward biased and 2500 ohm when reverse biased. What is the current in the diode for arrangement shown? Now to solve this question, we know V is equal to 5 volt. Then the diode is forward biased. Net resistance is equal to 10 ohm plus 25 ohm, which is equal to 35 ohm. I is equal to V by R, which is equal to 5 upon 35, which is equal to 1 by 7 ampere. No current in reverse bias. So now, option B, 1 by 7 ampere is the correct answer. In a reverse bias diode, when the applied voltage changes by 1 volt, the current changes by 0.5 microampere. What is the reverse bias resistance of the diode? Now we know that reverse bias resistance R is equal to delta V by delta I, which is equal to 1 upon 0.5 into 10, 0.5 into 1 raised to minus 6, which is equal to 10 raised to 6 upon 1 by 2. Now, 10 raised to 6 upon 1 by 2, which is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 6 ohm. So, option B, 2 into 10 raised to 6 ohm is the correct answer. Which of the following diodes is reverse biased? For reverse biasing of a diode, the P side of the junction diode should be lower potential than N side. So, P side should be lower then N side. For diodes in the figure ACD, P side is at higher potential, hence they are forward biased. For diode B, N side is at 5 volt, while P side is at zero potential. Therefore, B is reverse biased. So option A, figure 2, is the correct answer. What is value for DC voltage if a half wave rectifier is converting AC voltage? V is equal to 100 sine 314t into DC. So V is equal to 100 sine 314t. V0 is equal to 100 volt. VAC. In half wave rectifier, the value of DC voltage in one cycle is given by VAC is equal to V0 upon pi, which is equal to 100 upon 3.14, which is equal to 31.85 volt, which is approximately equal to 32. So option C, 32 volt is the correct answer. For transistor, beta is equal to 50. To change collector current by 350 microampere, the base current should be changed by. So we know beta is equal to 50, which is equal to delta IC upon delta IB. Therefore, delta IB is equal to delta IC upon beta, which is equal to 350 upon 50 microampere. So option D, 350 upon 50 microampere is the correct answer. A PN photodiode is made of a material with a band gap of 20 eV. The minimum of the radiation that can be absorbed, the minimum frequency of radiation that can be absorbed by the material is nearly. Now to solve this question, we know band gap H nu, which is equal to 2 electron volt, which is equal to 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joules. The minimum frequency, that is H nu minimum, is equal to 2 electron volt. So V minimum is equal to 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 upon H. Now, this is written as 3.2 into 10 raised to minus 19 upon 6.6 into 10 raised to minus 34, which gives us 0.5 into 10 raised to 15, which is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 14 hertz. So option D, 5 into 10 raised to 14 hertz is the correct answer. What is the Zener current in the following circuit? So this is the circuit which they have given. I is equal to 150 minus 50 upon 5 into 10 raised to 3. which on solving we get 20 milliampere. So option C, 20 milliampere is the correct answer. What is the load current in the following Zener circuit? Now to calculate the load current, Zener voltage is equal to 40 volt. IN is equal to 40 upon 16 into 10 raised to 3, which is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is equal to 2.5 milliampere. So option B, 2.5 milliampere is the correct answer.